Just one night, all we got. Just one night, all we got. Just one night, all we got. Just one night, all we got.
I ain't got time for you, baby. Either you're mine or you're not. Make up your mind, sweet baby. Right here, right now is all we got. A little party never killed nobody. So we gon' dance until we drop. A little party never killed nobody. Right here, right now is all we got.
Skeetin' bada pop.
Vulnerable years, my father gave me some advice that I've been turning over in my mind ever since. Whenever you feel like criticizing anyone, he told me, just remember that all the people in this world haven't had the advantages that you've had. In consequence, I'm inclined to reserve all judgments, which made me privy to the secret griefs of a wild, unknown man. Reserving judgments is a matter of infinite hope, after all. So, when I found myself in the presence of Gatsby, I recognized that he had an extraordinary gift for hope. I only met Gatsby when I came east, after serving in the war, to work in a bond business. I got a small place in West Egg, on Long Island Sound, next to a colossal, brand new mansion belonging to the man I would later come to know as Gatsby. Across the bay, the white palaces of East Egg glittered along the water, and the history of that summer really begins on the evening I drove over there to have dinner with the Buchanans. I had met Tom in college at New Haven, and his wife, Daisy, was my second cousin once removed. I had no idea why my cousin and Tom decided to come east, only that Daisy had told me it was a permanent move. Now, having seen them in a while, I realized that Tom had changed since his New Haven years. But Daisy was as charming as always.
Nikki, I'm paralyzed with happiness.
I'm glad to be here. I stopped in Chicago for a day on my way east. At least a dozen people asked me to send their love.
Oh, did they miss me?
The whole team is desolate. All the cars have left rear wheel painted black as morning reed.
How gorgeous. Let's go back, Tom, tomorrow. You ought to see the baby.
I'd like to.
She's asleep. She's 3 years old. Haven't you ever seen her? Anyhow, what sort of work are you in now, Nick?
I'm a bond man.
Well then, I'm sure I've never heard of who you're with.
You live in West Egg. I know somebody there.
Well, I don't know a single-
You must know Gatsby.
Gatsby? What Gatsby?
After the events of the dinner party, I made my way home, and when I reached my estate at West Egg, I ran the car under its shed and sat for a while on an abandoned grass roller in the yard. Suddenly, I saw that I was not alone. 50 feet away, a figure had emerged from the shadow of my neighbor's mansion and was stretching his arms out toward the dark water in a curious and fast I was from him. I could sworn he was trembling. Involuntarily, I glanced away, and when I looked back, I was alone again in the unquiet darkness. There is a certain desolate area about halfway between West Egg and New York, a valley of ashes. Ashes grow like crops in fields and rise like chimneys from roofs amid the powdery air of the valley. Above the place of obscure operations are the eyes of T.J. Eckelberg. They are blue and gigantic, and the retinas are 1 yard high.
Hello, well said, old man. How's business?
I can't complain. When are you going to sell me that car?
Next week. I've got my man working on it right now.
Works pretty slow, don't he?
No, he doesn't. And if you feel that way about it, maybe I'd rather sell it somewhere else after all.
Oh, I don't mean that. I just meant...
Honey, get some chairs, why don't you, so someone can sit down.
Oh, sure, sure.
I want to see you. Get on the next train.
All right.
I'll meet you by the newsstand on the lower level.
Thank you.
you live down on Long Island too?
I live at West Egg.
Really? I was down there about a month ago, at a man named Gatsby's. Do you know him?
I live next door to him.
Well, they say he's a nephew or a cousin of a Kaiser Williams. That's where all his money came from.
Really?
Yes. I'm scared of him. I'd hate to have him get anything on me. Neither of them can stand the person they're married to.
Can't they?
Can't stand them. What I say is, why go on living with them if you can't stand them? If I was them, I'd get a divorce and get married to each other right away.
Doesn't she like Wilson either?
No! Definitely not.
You see, it's really his wife that's keeping them apart. She's Catholic and they don't believe in divorce.
I almost made that mistake too. I was married to a man who was way below me. But if I hadn't met Chester, he'd have gotten me too. Sure.
Yes, but listen. At least you didn't marry him. I married him, and that's the difference between my case and yours.
Why did you, Myrtle? Nobody forced you to.
I married him because I thought he was a gentleman. I thought he knew something about breeding, but he wasn't fit to lick my shoe.
But you were crazy about him for a while.
The only crazy I was when I married him. I knew right away that I had made a mistake. He borrowed somebody's best suit to get married in, and he never even told me about it. And then the man comes after it one day when he's out.
Anyways, his wife's name's Daisy.
Daisy, that is such a nice name. Daisy, Daisy, Daisy. I will say it whenever I want to. Daisy, Daisy, Daisy. Daisy, 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 Daisy.
Oh, my nose.
City lights, the way you'd play.